Charlotte, North Carolina, the heart of the South, it's Crazy Late with Johnny Newwater. Tonight, join Johnny and his guest, actress Julie Emmons, comedian Donna Carter, musical guest Sarah Clanton Schaefer, and featuring Crackers and Snack Meat with James Lee Walker II. I'm Julie Scoggins, and now here he is, the titan of tomfoolery, Johnny Millwater!
I'm your host, Johnny Millwater, and you are in for a treat tonight. This may be the best show we've ever done. Don't you think, Julie?
Tonight's show is going to be better than a bacon-wrapped Krispy Kreme donut.
Now, you may notice that Sid Davis looks a lot better than he usually does. Because tonight, Sid is out working on the road doing something that pays more, apparently, so instead, we have here tonight one of the funniest women I've ever met, and definitely the funniest woman in Charlotte, North Carolina, Miss Julie Scoggins. Mrs. Julie Scoggins. Mrs. I call her Miss because in my heart I still hope. But how you doing, Julie?
Thank you. I'm well, and you look fabulous.
That was the...
Not every man can rock a pink tie.
Well, it's ladies' night here tonight. It's a special show. All of our guests are women. I am not. The band was supposed to dress up in drag, but only Phil did it. Why are you looking at me like that? But we do have a great show lined up for you, but we've got a kind of a crazy couple of stories. First of all, just I want to talk to you guys about something that's near and dear to my heart. I heard a rumor recently. What does that mean? You got it. I heard a rumor recently. For those of you who don't know, the studio is haunted. Every now and then I'll see a candle floating behind the camera or something. Don't let it frighten you at home. But I heard a rumor recently that one of my favorite actors, one of the greatest directors who ever lived, Clint Eastwood, I heard that he's actually looking to get a divorce from his wife of 17 years. Yeah. I heard he treated her like a piece of furniture. Cool. Apparently, Clint Eastwood was so upset, he changed his facial expression. Yeah, he went from squinty to even more squinty. Mm-hmm. Wow. Wow.
His wife was on the news last night defending him.
Really?
Yeah, so apparently he's not unforgiven.
They reconcile. Go ahead, make me gay. Now, you're probably asking yourself, was that 5 Clint Eastwood jokes or 6? All right, that's probably the world record for the most Clint Eastwood jokes ever. Fair enough. Hey, speaking of world records, I saw something interesting. We saw a cat online. There's a video of a cat online. I don't know if you've heard about this. There's lots and lots of videos of cats online, but there's a cat out of L.A. His name, I believe, is Colonel Meow. He has the longest hair in the history of cats. He just won the world record for the longest hair in the history of cats. Take a look at that guy right there. See him? That's Colonel Meow. Yeah. The previous record for hairiest kitty was held by Kesha. I'm a little embarrassed by that joke. A little bit. But here's another interesting story. Any Canadians here? How about Americans? Hey, perfect. Recently, a man got caught crossing the Canadian-American border underwater with scuba gear, trying to smuggle 8 pounds of marijuana into America. Underwater, yeah. Authorities aren't sure why he kept it in his anus. Yeah.
I bet it was easy for him to decompress.
Now it
Hey, that was some good shit. That was some good shit.
Now apparently Lake Michigan is the world's largest bomb.
And Detroit's the carburetor, I'm guessing.
Hey, here's an interesting story, and this is another one absolutely true. A woman in New York this week, she was having terrible abdominal pains, like bad cramps, and she went into the hospital. She thought she had appendicitis. It turned out that she was pregnant, unbeknownst to her, and she was going into labor. Yeah, that's kind of a sad story, because, I mean, appendicitis doesn't last 18 years. Here's a story from right around the corner. In Tennessee, a sheriff was recently reprimanded for firing his handgun in the air, trying to scare a turkey away from his car. So the first shot has been fired in the turkey versus bacon war. Pick a side!
Who can pick a side? Who can pick? They're both awesome. Can't you just have turkey bacon?
That would work too. That would work too. I can tell you're getting tired. I'm going to wrap this up with one last story, and I know you're going to enjoy this one, because this one is unbelievable. There was a woman in China. There's actually several. not as many as there ought to be. But there was a woman in China who got busted last week. She was stopped by police for breastfeeding her 18-month-old baby while driving a moped. And believe it or not, there's even a photograph of it. It's blurry, but it's real. It's real. Do you see that? That is so unsafe. She's not even wearing a helmet.
Like, that's the first time there's been a naked boob on the back of a bike. Come on. I've been to Sturgis.
You know, if you look really closely, she has a tattoo. It says, if you can read this, then the kid fell off. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a great show tonight. Julie Emmons is here from the Charlotte film community. The incredibly funny Donna Carter joins us here tonight. We have the return of the incredibly talented Sarah Clanton Schaefer. I am joined by the incomparable Julie Scoggins. And as always, The Rock.
Oh,
crackers and snack meat with James Lee Walker II. Take us home, boys. We'll be right back.
Crazy Late with Johnny Millwater is brought to you by Biggs Camera. For more than 40 years, Biggs Camera has offered the latest cutting-edge film and digital photographic equipment and hard-to-find and collectible items to all photographers, professionals, amateurs, and hobbyists. Biggs Camera, making photography simple since 1959.
The Vague News Network, with television's obscurest news team. Revolutionaries overthrow an oppressive government. Michelle Obama urges Americans to do something. Brangelina's ovulated. And drugs continue to be the number one cause of Americans getting high. All this and pandas tonight on VNN. Steve Vanilla on sports.
What a ball game!
Madame Ariana with her weather report.
Snow.
Food critic Roger Nussbaum. All this and nothing more on VNN. Vague news. All of the news, none of the facts. What's that behind you?
Don't you dare click that mouse. Crazy Late, we'll be right back.
Hi. Each year, millions of people choose sobriety. I'm here to tell you, don't do it. You don't have any fun. They always make you drive home. And lastly, how much fun is it to wake up every morning beside someone you know? Say no to sobriety.
We'll be right back.
welcome back to Crazy Late with Johnny Millwater. I am joined tonight, as I mentioned before, by an incredibly funny lady. Ms. Julie Scoggins is here tonight. Ms. Julie Scoggins. Thank you so much for filling in for Sid at the last minute. I appreciate you making the time to come here because I know you're traveling all across the country doing stand-up constantly. And I've been doing stand-up with, I think the first time we were together was almost 10 years ago, wasn't it?
Wow.
I think it was 10 years. That's how long we've been doing comedy.
Seems like 15. But
the show already feels like 45 minutes,
Knoxville.
Too. I understand.
Knoxville, Tennessee, if I remember correctly.
Oh, yeah. Those are good times. I think we left our mark on that town for sure. But what I love about you is... We did. What I love about you is you're a brilliant stand-up comic. You've been very successful at it. But you, I mean, this is all I've ever done. The only job I've ever had. You've had a lot of really interesting jobs. You've had
and
a lot of things.
And some not so interesting. But, yeah, I was, I was actually a Batgirl for the Charlotte O's.
You fought crime?
The Charlotte O's. Remember they were the Orioles first? Now they're the Knights.
They were.
They were the Knights as of last week. I guess they're done, at least in that incarnation. But, I was a Batgirl. The way they got me, not like da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah,
No.
That's what I pictured.
No. I was actually in modeling school at King's College. I'm 6'2", so my mother was trying to, cash in. And... Yeah, and I was just too tomboyish, She just wanted a little girl so bad. And but it wasn't working out anyway, thank you. Because they make you put a book on your head to walk straight and have good posture. And I'd ridden horses a lot and fallen a lot. And I had so many knots on my head that the book, I had to hold it like that to make the book stay. So the Charlotte Orioles came in and recruited the girls. We were sponsored by Dr. Pepper, and we were called Pepper Girls. And it was our job to, when the players hit, to run out on the field and pick the bat up and take it back to the dugout. And so
the other players still got the ball, right?
They played the ball, but they,
But
you had to pay
sports.
Attention because every now and then somebody would break a bat and the loose piece would fly over where you were sitting, filing your nails or whatever, and wake you up. But
this may not be appropriate. What would you wear? What,
little shorty shorts. Little shorty shorts. Pepper Girl outfits. They were very perky.
And your hair?
Yeah, they foo-fooed you all up.
So you could go out and grab a stick. They dressed you up, really.
Well, they were going for the bend over shot.
Ah.
I feel sure. Yo, they were.
Aren't we all?
And then the last year. The last year I was with the team, I was actually the mascot. The big dog, the big blue dog. That's in, and they actually made that suit to fit my measurements, and they had a big head. With a mesh, and you look through the mouth, and I had a bugle, honest to God bugle, like blowing the charge bugle, and I had them put a hole in the mouth of the dog. And so,
for the bugle?
Yes, and I
right.
was... And I would stand on the dugout and go... And they would all scream... So that was my...
So there you go. Yet another talent I didn't know you had.
And I was also, I worked at Eastland Mall back when it was a real mall. And I know it had a skating rink, man. And I worked at the pet center, Dr. Pet Center at Eastland Mall. I was a pooper scooper. And I know it didn't pay it worth a damn, but I quit that nail biting habit. So.
This may not be appropriate, but when you were a pooper scooper, what'd you wear?
I think it was a smock.
Oh, okay.
You
That's
know, they
look.
Made everybody look like doctors in there, And they had blowfish in this tank. And when you stir them up, they blow up. Oh, Lord, I'd wait till there wasn't anybody in there. And I'd go back there with that net, that dip net, and stick it in there and just give them a ride, boy. It takes a them like 30 minutes to go back down. It does.
I have the same
It was
problem.
Awesome. We didn't have cable yet. You got to understand. This was a long time ago. Oh, this is, by the way, when I was going to Independence.
Oh, a lot of Independence High School fans here.
Big eye. Yep, so, yep. A lot of Independence
people.
That's
the nickname for my, what?
What?
The big eyes?
The big eye. Big eye.
You had a Cyclops as a mascot?
Big eye. Flop.
I've never been to Independence High School. They don't let me into high schools anymore. And just because I'm full grown is the only reason. But that was it a guy dressed like an eye? Was it?
No, it was the Independence Patriots. Oh, okay. And we had the tri-corner hat.
All right.
And the knee breeches, you know, like colonial. Yeah, with the gold pants and the coat with the tails. Heck yeah, man. We played in the carousel parade and marched and all that crap. I was in the marching band.
Well, of all the jobs you've had, I think probably comedian's probably the best one, don't you think?
This is it.
Because you're amazing at it. You're one of the funniest people I've ever seen, and we're very lucky to have you. Thank you so much for being on the show with us. Stick around for more with Julie Scoggins. Hey, and we'll be right back with Julie Emmons from the Charlotte film community. See you then.
Thank you.
A B-less view here, folks, with the Pit Road Revival. At your local racetrack, Reverend B-less view, centers of the track. Come on, come on, with all your mechanical problems. E-drop valve is a my-drop valve. Hallelujah. A E-busted crank is a my-busted crank. Amen. Here comes one now. Roll within the pit there, fellers. How can I keep ye from the annals of purgatory there, sinner?
Yeah, Reverend, I don't know what's wrong with it. It just quit running, and I'm three laps down. You gotta hurry.
No problem there, Jesuit foot. Turn it over there, brother. Satan from ye cylinder heads, I say hail. The soul of ye timing chain must go and sin no more, I say hail. It's not getting no better. I say hail. Pump it, ye fool. Go, brother, go and may ye holy pistons come past the doors of Hades. That's the way it's done with Reverend B-less U's Pit Road Revival. Until next time, sinners. Hallelujah.
Gentlemen, our first guest tonight is the co-founder of the Charlotte film community, and she is also a very talented actress. Please give a warm welcome to Julie Emmons. Coming back on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Most people that come on the show, once they learn their lesson, they're gone forever. You are giving us another chance, and
I'm
really, really
teach.
Appreciate
That's what
it.
I
Thank
hear.
You so much for being here. Now, the great thing about you is that you are involved in almost every facet of show business here in Charlotte.
I feel like it sometimes.
I mean,
yeah.
What's your favorite thing to work on besides this show?
Oh, gosh. you know, I really actually find a lot of I really love casting, actually, I really do.
Really?
So I do, yeah, I do a lot of it. I act, I write screenplays.
I didn't know you wrote screenplays.
I do. A lot of times they turn out to be like murders, though, so I think there's something going on in there that I probably need to see somebody about. They start off really sweet, like, you know, about puppies and stuff, and they just end up bad. So they haven't gone anywhere.
Do you have a screenplay about a puppy committing murders?
No.
I'd read that.
The puppy's a victim, obviously, but...
Oh.
Well, that's why they're not going anywhere. I mean, you know, But no, I do. But I find a lot of it in casting. I love casting. I was actually talking to someone today about this girl's so super excited because I've gotten her this role, and it's something about just you made somebody's dream come true, and it feels good.
I bet.
So yeah, and I would say second
to
that.
Are you like an honest caster, or are you like one of those people you try to get dates, you try to pull tricks? I've heard stories.
You mean I'll have a casting couch? Is that what you're asking?
That's what I've heard about.
That's a casting secret that I can't let out.
Oh, okay. I don't know. I've never been cast in anything. I don't know how it works.
You don't know about that. Yeah.
You're gonna end up being a cast.
I would say, other than that, though, on the other side of that I love is I am the founder of Charlotte Film Community. Mm-hmm. At my heart. It's a labor of love, absolutely.
And for those of you that don't, and I'm a big fan, I try to go to as many meetings as I can. You have one meeting a month.
I do.
But what is the goal of the Charlotte Film Community?
Charlotte Film Community was founded, and the goal was to bring everybody in the film world of Charlotte, particularly, together to network, to get to know each other. And the idea was, back when it was created, was there was no film in Charlotte. And so we all got together, and we were like, well, we'll make film. You don't give us any film, we'll make it, and we'll get it out. And we did, and
really
I don't like to take all of the credit for the state that film is in right now, North Carolina.
Go ahead.
I'm going to take it.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
You did it. And there's lots of film. I think some of the biggest movies of the year, what is it?
Absolutely.
Hunger Games was shot
Iron
here.
Man.
Iron Man 3 was right down the street.
Yeah, absolutely. Right? We had a huge Melissa McCarthy, Susan Sarandon comedy this summer called Tammy. So we've had a lot of really big things happen.
I want to be in those things. Can you make some calls next time you do casting?
I'll see what I can do.
And what is it that you're working on now? I understand you have something to show us.
Actually, I finished this project a while back. It's a film called Marbles, and I was one of the leads in it. My fantastic filmmaker, his name is Rory Karp. He's amazing. He's
Karp?
Yeah, we know him.
I love Rory Karp. He's also a comedian.
Yes.
He's the only person who's ever given me an acting job ever. He put me in one of ESPN movies. I love Rory Karp. He's my
hero.
I
did not know that. I love him. He's fantastic.
Oh, he's so talented.
Well, you're going to love this then.
I know I will. What's the name of it again?
It's called Marbles.
Is there anything we need to know about the clip?
It's not very funny. I guess that's... Oh. We're going to need to liven things up when this is over.
That'll fit right in then.
Yeah.
Well, let's take a look. This is the trailer for Marbles by Rory Karp.
Daddy, I think I lost my marbles. Hey, Daddy. Uncle Mommy smiled at me.
Mommy hit her head really hard. And ever since then, she's been sad for no real reason. Daddy's trying to get Mommy the help she needs. We need.
Like laughing now? Does anyone need a tissue? Or
that was amazing.
It was
first of all, Rory is the man. We were just talking about
him
again. I'm such a big fan of him.
And that's his 5-year-old.
Yes. Oh,
and Cooper is the best actor ever. He is amazing. If he took one more bite of that cereal, I was going to applaud him because he just kept doing it. I couldn't believe it.
That's commitment.
I was getting sick watching him eat that cereal. But, he was fantastic. He was
the best. How
many
takes did he have to do with the cereal?
Like 742. Like, at least.
Wow.
Yeah,
Rory only made me do 2.
It was disgusting after a while. It was terrible.
Do you think he was just skinny and he was trying to deal with his own son's problem? He was like,
I didn't think of that.
Let's take that shot with the pie again. Let's see how that goes. You were also amazing. Who else was in the clip? Who was the gentleman?
There was a Chicago actor named Charles Rasmussen.
Ooh.
And Rasmussen.
And, he used to be the emperor of Russia, didn't he?
For a while, but now he's into acting. And then a very talented Charlotte actor who I think you should have on the show, named Patrick Heenan, fantastic actor.
We don't have men on the show.
Oh, well, he could dress in drag. I mean,
we'd be thrilled to have him on. Absolutely.
Yeah, he's fantastic and probably one of the best actors in Charlotte, hands down. So.
Well, I'd like to know who's who, and it's wonderful to have you on. Now, what's going on in the Charlotte film community? Do you have any events coming up that you'd like to talk about?
We just finished our big Made in Charlotte competition in August. It was amazing. It was so good. We did a commercial. You had to create a commercial or a PSA or an ad announcement. Incredible entries. It was so good. We had a celebrity board judge them and had a big party to celebrate the winner. And it was so good. And then, you know, we're moving into our fifth year. So we are so excited.
Congratulations. 5 years. It's hard to do.
I just love it.
How can people be a part of the Charlotte film community?
If you ever want to be involved, you don't have to even be involved in film. You just, if you want to see what it's about, get involved in film, whatever. We meet monthly on the first Tuesday of every month, unless there's a holiday like there was this week. We pushed it out a week, so our next meeting is next week on the 10th. You can find anything about us on our website, which is charlottefilmcommunity.com, and you can also find us on Facebook.
Fantastic. So come be a part of the Charlotte film community. Thank you so much, Julie Ammons,
absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with the very funny Donna Carter.
The Vague News Network, with television's obscurest news team.
A major company recalls their merchandise for being deadly. Worried? Gas prices continue. Anderson Cooper has been assaulted by haters. A new study proves that meth labs are kind of dangerous. All that and sexting tonight on VNN.
Steve Vanilla on sports.
Both teams gave a great effort.
Madame Ariana with her weather report. Food critic Roger Newsbaum. All this and nothing more on VNN. Vague news. All of the news, none of the facts.
Hi there. My name's Andy Davis, and I'm here to tell you, please, don't leave your house. Think about this. You won't have to worry about things like poisonous insects, bad weather, people who want to sue you. Please. Don't leave your house. The world is a scary place. You don't want to see it.
Ha-ha! Say, do you hate rush hour traffic?
And high fives?
Then you'll love Real Americans with Butch and Skeeter. I'm your host, Butch Hockersmith.
And I'm Skeeter Dunn.
And we're real Americans talking about real American issues.
Like ice cream.
So watch Real Americans with Butch and Skeeter, Thursdays at 11:30.
Make sure to watch.
Or the terrorists win.
Ladies and gentlemen, our comedian guest tonight is a local Charlottean. She is the Southern Belle with a heart of cornbread. From Nashville, Tennessee, please welcome Donna Carter.
Thank you very much. I want to ask you to keep that going. I am celebrating a birthday. Thank you. I am 55 years old. I don't look it, do I? Hell no, I don't. It's because fat girls don't wrinkle. Remember that, you bony balds out here. You know who you are. And they always say the same thing, don't they? Those skinny girls, they say stuff like, oh, I forget to eat. And they say it like it's some kind of eating disorder, forgetting to eat. The hell kind of eating disorder is that? That's an eating disorder, then I have bulimia. I just forget to vomit. But I went to the doctor last week for my annual checkup. He said, Donna, honey, I need you to lose a little weight. A little. Truth be told, y'all, I need to lose about the equivalent of one of Queen Latifah's titties, you know. Half of Britney Spears, something. He said, Donna, I want you to work out, get in shape, work out, work out, meat, work out. Fat chance that's going to happen. Because I got to tell y'all, some people work out and they get big muscles. I work out, I get my big ass tired. But I did try to go to the gym, and I got there and the smoothie machine was broke. I was pissed. Got ready to leave, the little trainer fella said, Miss Donna, which one of those machines do you like the best? I said, machines? How about that one that opens and closes the door to get my fat ass out of here? Woo! That's the one I like. He said, no, I'm talking about the Nautilus. I'm like, Nautil this. They make me tired. So that didn't work out. I went to the mall, took up some of that mall walking. Third time past that Cinnabon. Y'all, I'd gain my big ass 2 pounds. I ain't lying to you. I ought not put a Cinnabon in the mall. Pisses me off. I tell you what else pisses me off. We've long gone lawsuit crazy in America now, haven't we? Yeah, and it's nuts, nuts, nuts. And we're suing over the stupidest stuff, too. You got people smoking cigarettes, suing the cigarette manufacturers because they got lung cancer, they're dead and they're dying. And y'all, there's this man, he's up in New York City right now. He is suing McDonald's because he ate him a quarter pounder with cheese and got him a big ass. Well, I'm putting y'all on notice. I am fixing to sue Jose Cuervo. Because somebody needs to pay for them ugly men I slept with in my 20s. Thank you. They start paying for regret, my fat ass will be a millionaire. Do you hear me? But y'all, the doctor diagnosed me with this real rare medical condition. I have what they call gastroparesis. There's some insensitive people up in here tonight. For those of you that don't know, that's a paralyzed stomach. I'll let you insert your open joke right there. I got nothing. But y'all, the first thing my doctor told me to do was to increase my intake of fiber. So I got me some of that Beneful. Yeah, that is dog food. People, I went through 3 bags of that before I realized he had said been a fiber. Of course, it stays crunchy even in milk. Woo! And y'all, he's got me on this experimental drug. I am taking Viagra. Yeah, fellas, that means I'm packing. The doctor told me, he said, Donna, you know, you're going to have good side effects and bad side effects. Bad side effects are all I want to do, you know, scratch my crotch and do the remote and spit, you know. Good side effects are y'all for a couple hours every day. I got perky titties.
Pastry.
Yes, I do. He told me if it lasted longer than 4 hours to call him. Yeah. That lasts longer than 4 hours. I am calling everybody. Look! I got tiggle bitties. And speaking of my tiggle bitties, have any of you invested in the Genie bra yet? Whoa, there you go. Let me tell you about this happy piece of crap. I was in a morphine-induced stupor. And I got a halt to my credit card, and I ordered up a passel. And that's a shitload of them Genie bras. 6 weeks later, the tractor trailer truck pulled up in my neighborhood. Y'all, it took a tow motor, a pallet jack, and 6 Mexicans to get all them bras off the back of that truck. And I don't know why they call it the genie bra. She ain't granted me one wish till yet. I mean, these things are too old to lactate. You know, let's have them do something cool like shoot tequila or something. And if you haven't seen it, y'all, they got the genie cami, and I'm wearing one. Shut up, that ain't funny. Y'all, there's no zipper, there's no duct tape, there's nothing. And it's one big ass piece, which means I got to start it down here. And I got the wiggle. And I got the wiggle. What I'm trying to tell you, people, is this is controlled. Now, gentlemen, you remember that first date and you got that girl home and you got her out of her Wonder Bra and there weren't much titty there as you thought there would be. Well, the exact opposite is true here. There will be disappointment. Johnny, I don't want to get off this stage. I will leave you with one final thought this evening, y'all, and I mean this in all sincerity. We're in a war, coming out, thank goodness, of a little bit of depression. That Kim Kardashian heifer had a baby, and I'm gonna tell you what, God even went, "Oh man, I didn't mean to do that," and. But you know, y'all, I mean this in all sincerity. There's always somebody in this world trying to make you mad, trying to get you sad, trying to get you down, ain't they? Do not let them do that to you, ladies and gentlemen. You have complete and total control over your life. I'm going to tell you how to do that tonight, and I want you to take this tip from me to you. And remember it always. It takes 34 muscles to frown, ladies and gentlemen, but only 7 to rear back and bitch slap that ass hat. Hey, Scott! You've been a lot of fun. My name is Donna Carter. Thank you.
Donna Carter, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thank
Stick
you.
Around. We'll have more with Donna Carter right after this. Hilarious. Could that have gone better?
The Vague News Network, with television's obscurest news team.
China has more people than ever. Two people that are better than me getting married. Olympic athletes test positive for Wheaties.
Teens have found a new way of getting high, and they're doing it right now.
All that in taxes tonight on BNN.
Steve Vanilla on sports.
That game was a doozy.
Madame Ariana with her weather report.
It's nice for now.
Movie critic Roger Nussbaum. All this and nothing more on BNN. Vague News. All of the news, none of the facts.
If you'd like to be part of our studio audience, send an email, questtickets@crazylate.com, and receive up to 4 tickets for our next taping.
Oh, that's one heck of a show.
Yeah. Hey, Jimmy, who was that lady I saw you with the other night?
That was no lady. That, my friend, was a skank.
I hope you used a condom.
Condoms? Condoms are for squares.
Hey, don't you know skanks have more diseases than whores?
Yeah, and I call my condom the members only jacket.
I got 2 on right now.
Yeah, Jimmy, you already have too many babies.
Besides, you can take a rubber glove, cut the fingers off. You get 5 in 1.
You know what, guys? You're right. I'm gonna wear a condom every time I bang a skank from now on.
Yes.
Never trust a skank. Take that to the bank.
James Lee Walker II, everybody. One more time.
Hello, people.
Rocking it. Rocking it. We are back with the incredibly funny Donna Connor. Thank you so much for being here, Donna.
Thank you. Thank you.
Is that amazing? Fantastic. It's your first time on the show, but I've known you for years. It's been, what, 7, 8 years since we've actually shared a stage together?
Johnny, make it about 11, sweetheart.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I lost track.
Math wasn't his strong suit, I don't reckon. He didn't go to Independence High School either.
Didn't go to high school.
Oh, Lord. No, Johnny, it's been 11 or 12 years. It was right about 2002, 2003. That makes 10. My math is better. And anyway, we worked together on a cruise ship.
Did we really?
Do you remember that? Yeah, the only time I remember.
You sure that was me?
Yeah, I know it was you. You were a balloon-eating fool. Yes, people, he ate balloons.
I used to smuggle. We've all had side gigs in the past.
Smuggle my ass. I don't know. No, he ate balloons.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He was a really cool magic act, and he ate balloons, and he was very funny. And I've been in love with him ever since. I don't know.
I'm just finding out more about you just today than I did last time working with you. We hardly ever got to hang out. I didn't even know you were from Charlotte. I didn't know you were a Charlottean. I'm sorry.
I just don't even know what to say at this point. Bless your heart. I mean,
I guess that's the best thing to say on TV. Yeah.
Yeah. Bless his heart.
But you left us. You moved away
from
Charlotte.
I did. I moved to Middle Tennessee.
Why would you do that?
Well,
it's such a wonderful town here.
Well, it is a wonderful town. It's a great comedy scene, and I got started with my friend here, Julie Scoggins. We were in the very first comedy class that was offered here in Charlotte. Yeah. Yep.
Comedy classes.
1998.
Wow.
1998, that's how long we've been doing this, and I can't do that math. So, but yeah.
You and Julie, and also Paul Hooper,
Paul Hooper was in that class.
Incredibly funny professional comedian out there right now.
Yep, and Eric Grady's doing comedy, that's right.
Eric Grady was a guest on this very show a few months ago.
Very, very tall. Tall, makes her look little. And really. Randy Manson, but he's not doing comedy anymore, is he? He is really little. He was the opposite of all them, and because we had another guy in the class that played professional basketball in Luxembourg, so he wasn't little either, is what I'm trying to tell you. And y'all, Luxembourg is a country.
Okay,
it's across the ocean.
Yeah. And it's only that big. They have to play half court.
Well, yeah, they have to play. Yeah. He used to say that he could shoot from one end of the country to the other. But I moved out there for a day job because, you know, sometimes it's hard to make a living doing this comedy thing unless mm-hmm. you're a rock star like Julie and you. And anyhow, said all that to say this. That I kind of like Middle Tennessee, but it's not Charlotte. Charlotte will always be home, and I'm thrilled. Thank you for the opportunity to have been here tonight.
You're amazing tonight.
Thank you.
Amazing. I mean, you were funny back when I knew you, but you're unbelievably funny now. You've gone like 7 levels up. You're incredible.
Well, thank you, Johnny. You don't have to blow smoke where you used to smuggle. The audience loved me. That's enough.
I got no reason to lie to you, Donna. I got no reason to lie to you.
Thank
I was sitting
you.
Over there laughing my ass off, and you should
thank
know
you,
that.
Thank you.
And I've heard a rumor that you're actually thinking of leaving comedy. Is that true? You're actually, I saw something about you. You want to be head of security at an airport. You want
to
go to the dark
Charlotte,
side.
Yeah, in Charlotte, Well, I hear Jerry Orr's got his panties in a wad and kind of screwed up some stuff out there. And so I thought, well, you know who I'm talking about, right?
I don't.
Well, Johnny, if you would stay the hell home, you could figure out what was going on in town. Anyway.
Well, give me some context. Who's Jerry Orr?
He's the head of, and been the head of the airport for about 167 years.
I thought it was Douglas. I thought Douglas was in charge
of
the airport.
No, Douglas was just a guy that worked out there.
All
and
right.
Jesus. Anyway, so yeah, I was going to say that was going to be, but hey. I came into town yesterday to do this, and you know, because I'm a diva, I have to come in early. And shut up. And I was riding down South Boulevard, y'all, and there's this big U-Haul place there, and I don't know, it's Sharon Red West, and they're real proud of this sign that they got out front about storing your wine. Folks, you hadn't made it if you're storing your wine at the U-Haul, all right? I don't care if it's climate controlled or not, all right? You need to invest in one of them little bitty ones till better times come. That's all I'm saying.
I store my wine in my tummy.
See? Mine's in the box in the refrigerator, but I got a... Shut up. I got a nipple on a bottle in the car, and
that keeps the cops off you.
I can drive fast, and whew, I'm sweating like Casey Anthony at Babies R Us. I'm glad y'all laugh. That joke kills in Florida. Y'all want to guess what segment of the show is going to be cut out?
We lack the technology. It's all staying in. We may play this part twice until we get sponsors to fill up the commercial slots. But I'm so glad that things are going so well for
you,
Don. And I understand you got a brand new CD. We got two copies of it so we can listen to it in stereo. It's right there. It's called Donna Carter Live, Fat Girls Don't Wrinkle 2.
Volume 1. And this is still Volume 1.
Another copy of Volume 1. The card says 2. I don't know things. I'm amazed I pronounced your name correctly.
Well,
you also have T-shirts, you have bumper stickers, you have refrigerator magnets, you have home pregnancy tests. You are doing incredible merchandising work.
And I know you are the merchandising queen. I've even got some belly button lint I'll sell real cheap. And it's all on my website, DonnaCarter.com.
Mm-hmm.
And you can follow you can like my Facebook fan page, and you can follow me on the Twitter. Now, I don't have a lot of followers, but I am telling you that the Pope follows me, so I'm...
Which one?
The real one.
He's the best one.
Yeah, not that little wimp thing that couldn't last till he died. Anyway,
Really?
I'm just saying that, he got two poop to Pope, Julie.
Two poop to Pope!
I'm just saying y'all might want to pay attention, because I might be the way to heaven.
Well, it's been heaven having you on the program.
Oh, I'm way to wrap it up there.
I hope that you'll come back and see us again real soon. Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you,
John.
Donna
Carter.
Thank y'all. Thank you.
We'll be right back with Sarah Clanton Schaefer. Stick around.
The Vague News Network, with television's obscurest news team. France continues its production of the French. Congress still kinda disagrees. A famous sprinter runs unusually fast. Continued turmoil in the Gulf. All that and a shocking video tonight on VNN. Steve Vanilla on sports.
That ball game was a rocket buster.
Madame Ariana with her weather report.
It's dry heat.
Movie critic Roger Nussbaum. All this and nothing more on VNN. Vague news. All of the news, none of the facts.
Oh, hi!
saying. Do you love fur coats?
And big rigs?
Then you'll love Real Americans with Butch and Skeeter. I'm your host, Butch Hockersmith.
And I'm Skeeter Dunn.
And we're Real Americans talking about real American issues.
Like meat.
So check out Real Americans with Butch and Skeeter, Thursdays at 11:30.
Make sure to watch.
Or the terrorists win.
Karate. Some people think it's okay to teach their kids karate. They think putting them in a white suit with a colored belt makes them above the law. Well, it doesn't. So tell your stupid kid to stop kicking me.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, our musical guest tonight is appearing for the third time on the program. She's one of the most talented women I've ever seen in my entire life, and one of the reasons I love doing this show. She is here performing a song called Chasing a Feeling. Please welcome Sarah Clanton Schaefer and the Clanton Road.
Thank you very much.
So much. Check out her new CD, Chasing a Feeling. And thank you so much for being on the show. Sarah Clanton Schaefer.
Johnny Millwater, everybody.
And Clanton Road. Stick around, we'll be right back.
The Vague News Network, with television's obscurest news team. Some new toy is really hard to buy. North Korea's still mad about something. On American Idol this week, some guy sang. And at the big award show, rich people got dressed up fancy. All that and an intoxicated Lindsay Lohan tonight on VNN. Steve Vanilla on sports.
I've never seen two teams play so hard.
Madame Ariana with her weather report.
Seek shelter.
Movie critic Roger Nussbaum. All this and nothing more on VNN. Vague news. All of the news, none of the facts.
You're watching Crazy Late with Johnny Millwater. Good call.
There's an epidemic sweeping the country right now, and we've got to get to the bottom of it. White girls with ass. Aren't you sick and tired of the padding and stuffing of jeans, business slacks, even boy shorts? I earn mine one Krispy Kreme at a time. So if you, like me, are sick and tired of this gluteal mockery, join me and say, if you didn't grow it, you shouldn't show it.
Stick around for more Crazy Late with Johnny Millwater.
Thank you so much for watching Crazy Late with Johnny Millwater. Thanks once again to my guests, Julie Emmons. Yeah! The incredibly funny Donna Carter. Sarah Clanton Schaefer and Clanton Road. Julie Scoggins. Once again for Crackers and Snack Meat with James Lee Walker II. Thanks to all of you for watching. Thanks to the Comedy Zone for giving us a place to play. And until next time, be good, but not too good. Good night.
Hey, man.